Es raro. La sensación es rara, es confusa. Se habló del huracán, pero de ahí a que dijeron que iba a ser algo más fuerte que Irma y que nos iba a azotar fuerte y que iba a atravesar la isla, fue como estrésico.
People need to prepare themselves to be in solidarity with the struggle in Puerto Rico as the struggle in Puerto Rico develops.
No podemos acceder a internet. Acá en este campo no hay redes. Te mueven de un lado, que tienes que hacer una querella con la policía y vas al cuartel y te dicen que no es necesario una querella, que vayas a FEMA, pero entonces tú vas a FEMA, dale el nombre, apuntarte en una lista, porque no hay nada más, no hay realmente acción.
Que digan en realidad lo que está pasando en Puerto Rico. Y estamos sin luz y sin agua, ya vamos para 3 semanas. Este es el pueblo de Puerto Rico que más barrios tiene 23 barrios. Y hay barrios que todavía no se ha podido llegar a ver cómo está la gente. Hay gente en los barrios que no ha recibido nada todavía.
Esta máquina quedó entejada completamente en esos árboles. La reparamos, pero volvió, se nos rompió aquí. Nos hemos tenido que hacer obligados porque aquí no ha venido nada de gobierno. Nosotros estamos sin gobierno. El gobierno dijo que venía una gran tormenta y que estaban preparados para todo.
Porque están diciendo por allá que en Puerto Rico no ocurrió nada. Sí. Y no es la verdad.
Puerto Rico is part of the United States. We didn't do this to Katrina. We didn't do this to Harvey. Shame on us. We need to do much better. So let me read to you what one of our nurses, Erin Carrera, said. Yesterday we went to Utuado, a town up in the center of the island. We stopped many times along the way to educate people on water safety. They have received no provisions. There is no running water, no electricity. Nobody is aware of the risk of drinking untreated water. These communities are at great risk for waterborne illness epidemic. They need clean water that is safe to drink. These conditions would not be tolerated in any of the 50 states. It is outrageous that we are leaving our fellow Americans with essentially no aid. More will die if we do not step up.
Bueno, yo sinceramente he escuchado que lo que hay es cadáveres. Y he escuchado con gente que de verdad pues, se pasan aquí, rondean aquí, y sé que lo que hay ahí son cadáveres. Porque ahí no va a haber crema, no va a haber ni pollo, ni chuleta, ni nada. Lo que hay son cadáveres. Han sido bien irresponsables en cuanto a manejar el manejo que llevan.
The deaths the day of the hurricane are one thing. Every death after that, that has to do with not having the appropriate medical conditions, not having the appropriate sanitary conditions, not having the appropriate health conditions, not having the appropriate food or water intake. Those are deaths related to Maria.
People here are starving. Some people have died from dehydration. People here are drinking contaminated water. We need tools to survive in the immediate sense. But we also need the support as we go through the process of demanding what we have a right to in this country.
There is a problem with our drinking water. People are drinking from creeks or from rivers where the animals are dying. We already had some confirmed deaths of leptospirosis. Which usually you get when rats urinate in places, but also when animals die in the same bodies of water that people are drinking from. We already have scabies and conjunctivitis and gastritis at alarming rates. And if you're not well hydrated and you don't have access to the appropriate medical attention, a gastritis can kill you. We still don't have the basics. Things that are essentially human rights. The United Nations say all humans should have access to drinking water.
Que a la gente nuestra la están dejando sufrir y no sé si es con un propósito porque todo el mundo sabe que hay ayudas aquí pero no llega a la gente que las necesita. Que cómo es posible que tengan almacenada el agua en montones de sitios aquí y no la distribuyen, que no llegan las ayudas y los alimentos.
Así que el asunto de la alimentación yo creo que es primordial. Estamos teniendo un problema también con el agua. Hay brotes en nuestras comunidades, lo hemos visto. No solamente, ¿verdad?, aquí en Loíza, pero tenemos presencia en comunidad. Ya hemos hecho más de 400 assessments en las familias y hemos visto brotes de conjuntivitis, sarna humana.
It's not like they're saying, we're not getting fixed. We're not getting power. I'm over here getting water for myself, my family, and neighbors. It's 55 gallons a piece. I cannot get no more. Try to come twice a day. Try to help as much people as I can. Right now I'm getting this water to clean and help the elderly in Villajoco, Puerto Rico. That's the town in Toalta. They got really ravaged. Right now they got a contagion of conjunctivitis and we have no medical supplies or anything. And about the conjunctivitis, yeah, I got it myself. That's why I know about it. That's why I'm keeping my glasses on. I don't want to spread it. I don't want to shake your hands, cousin.
Don't believe the statistics. Don't believe what people are telling you. I have no agenda here. I'm a nurse. The CDC hasn't reached out to us to get any of our data. There should be a CDC camp right here debriefing nurses on the daily when we come home at night at 8 p.m. when we've been out since 6 and 7 o'clock in the morning. No one's asking us that data. To where should be, no one's come and said, what community do you think needs to be seen first tomorrow?
It's not a lot of Clorox that you put on water. You just add a few drops.
Okay.
A gallon of water, you could put like 5 drops per gallon to preserve that water, to kill most of the bacteria, which it doesn't really take all of it away. In there, I put about a little capful of Clorox. In there, that's 55 gallons. That water is not safe. But they're not supplying enough drinking water for people.
In Puerto Rico, they have refined colonialism to such of extent that people have been taught to accept the inferiority of us as a people. Somehow, the Americans are more capable. We need them to govern us. We need them to tell us what's best for us. Because we don't have the capacity to figure that out for ourselves. We don't have the capacity to join the international community and make our way the way every other nation has the capacity to do it.
No podemos seguir permitiendo que nos aplasten así, de una manera tan descarada, abusiva. Nosotros nos estábamos ayudando solo hasta que fuimos colonizados y no podemos idolatrar eso, no podemos idolatrar el abuso ni el maltrato. Tenemos que idolatrarnos a nosotros, los que hemos mantenido esto vivo, porque yo creo que fácilmente pudiésemos ser otra cosa completamente. Y hay algo que todavía me pregunto concretamente qué es, pero hay algo que definitivamente nos mantiene. Hay algo latiendo ahí todavía en nosotros. Hay que abrir camino y eventualmente reconstruir todo esto.
Estamos sobreviviendo y sabemos que Puerto Rico siempre, el puertorriqueño, siempre echamos para adelante y nos ayudamos siempre los unos a los otros. Yo soy de las que creo que uno lucha en su país, en su pueblo, que trata de ayudar, porque uno tiene que quedarse en su país, tratar de luchar lo más que uno pueda, para tratar de echarlo para adelante. Y tú sabes, y en eso estamos.
Esta es la olla común. Este es un centro de comida, pero donde también nos apoyamos mutuamente. No es un comedor social, porque las personas que vienen a comer no solamente vienen a comer, sino que también nos dicen sus destrezas. Nosotros vamos llamando, por ejemplo, si en la comunidad hace falta alguien que le ponga un techo, pues llamamos a las personas que dijeron que son carpinteros que vinieron a comer aquí. O sea que tenemos un registro de cada persona que viene a comer, porque el propósito es unir fuerza, ¿verdad? Porque nosotros no nos separamos de la comunidad, sino que nosotros todos somos parte de esta comunidad también. Entonces, pues así nos ayudamos mutuamente. Que se escuche y que se vea y que se sienta que Puerto Rico se está levantando, porque nosotros mismos nos estamos levantando, o sea, nos estamos ayudando mutuamente a levantarnos. Ningún gobierno nos está levantando a nosotros.
Well, I think for young people, you know, the world is in your hands. I'm an old man, but the world and the future of it is in your hands.
I'm gonna leave now, right? After a crisis like this? Nah. I prefer staying and helping people than going out and doing nothing. At least, that's my way of thinking.
No, yo me planifico quedar. Precisamente por eso es que estamos haciendo lo que hacemos.
No reciben agua, no reciben comida, y ese es el problema mayor que hay, ¿entiendes? ¿Entiendes? Y ese es el desafío que estamos viviendo diariamente los puertorriqueños. Yo lo puedo resumir todo en esa palabra: crisis humanitaria, lo que se está viviendo en Puerto Rico. Ciertamente.
¡Háblame para que mándalo para allá, para que tú quieras!
I mean, like our indigenous brothers and sisters said, water is life, and that's what's needed right now, clean water. That's it. What does that mean? That means buying a water portable filtration system and bringing it on your own so it doesn't get sequestered at the port. It means connecting with community groups on the ground. That's number one, okay? And people have to understand that this entire water system is contaminated. After that, it's power. And how we do power with solar, and how then do we have forms of communication that don't depend on a cell tower, and food. Those are the immediate needs, because the people of Puerto Rico cannot even function a daily, quote, normal life without the bare basic necessities. I wanted to do for everybody on this crew who's younger than me what elders had done for me in the past. I thought that it'd be critically important that I bring a group of younger, like Latino, Latina, Latinx, some Boricua, but all Latino folks together to document and tell the stories of really what was going on in Puerto Rico. And I think our first people were like, well, what film crew and what news organization? And I was like, nah, we're making our own. We're PR on the map.
Join all of our donors who support independent, unapologetic, unfiltered media by going to PRonTheMap.com, hashtag PRonTheMap on Twitter, and following us on Facebook. Donate, share these stories, and continue to learn more and uplift the rising up of Puerto Rico and the people of Puerto Rico.
borinqueño que han dado la señal. Despierta de ese sueño que es hora de luchar. A ese llamar patriótico no arde tu corazón. Ven, no será simpático el ruido de cañón. Nosotros queremos la libertad, nuestros machetes nos la darán. Vámonos, borinqueños.